Hello everyone, my name is Rafael Kramann and I'm chair of the Department of Medicine 2 at RWTH Aachen University Hospital, as well as the head of the Kramann Laboratory. My lab focuses on investigating the molecular mechanisms driving fibrosis. Fibrosis is considered the final common pathway of virtually all chronic injury to organs and tissues and destroys the architecture of organs leading to organ failure. We have previously identified a novel perivascular Gli1 cell population that drives fibrosis. After injury, Gli1 cells detach from capillaries, migrate to the interstitium and differentiate into collagen-producing myofibroblasts. However, we still lack a complete understanding of molecular mechanisms driving Gli1 cell activation and expansion. Here, we aim to unravel these mechanisms with the ultimate goal to identify novel therapeutic strategies to treat fibrosis.
To decipher Gli1 cell activation, we use transgenic Gli1-CER TD tomato mice in which we tag Gli1 expressing cells with the fluorophore TD tomato by tamoxifen injection. Next, tagged mice were subjected to unilateral ureter obstruction surgery, which leads to fibrotic remodeling of the kidney. Finally, we sacrificed the mice and sorted Gli1 expressing TD tomato positive cells. By analyzing gene expression with a microarray, we identified the metalloprotease ADAMTS12 as one of the top upregulated genes in activated Gli1 cells. As other metalloproteases have been reported to influence fibrosis, we decided to further investigate ADAMTS12. In a first step, we subjected wild-type and ADAMTS12 knockout mice to UUO surgery. Confirming our hypothesis, we found that ADAMTS12 knockout mice developed significantly less fibrosis. Next, we aim to evaluate a potential pro-fibrotic effect of ADAMTS12 in a second organ. Here, we performed myocardial infarction or sham surgery in wild-type and ADAMTS12 knockout mice. In line with our observations in kidney fibrosis, loss of ADAMTS12 led to a significantly smaller scar size and decreased fibrosis after myocardial infarction. More crucially, we confirmed that loss of ADAMTS12 improved left ventricular ejection fraction. In consequence, we showed that ADAMTS12 not only drives fibrosis, but also loss of cardiac function. Overall, our data indicate that ADAMTS12 knockout mitigates fibrosis after injury in both heart and kidneys.
To study the mechanism by which ADAMTS12 promotes fibrosis, we created a CRISPR-Cas9-mediated ADAMTS12 knockout in human PDGF receptor beta-expressing fibroblast. We then rescued its expression by introducing an overexpression plasmid of catalytically active or inactivated ADAMTS12. Interestingly, initial bulk RNA sequencing of all three cell lines pointed towards a perturbation of primarily migration-associated genes, but not ECM genes. Recently, several studies revealed a yet unknown fibroblast heterogeneity. We therefore questioned whether ADAMTS12 actually drives the differentiation to myofibroblast, or rather to a distinct fibroblast subtype. Mapping ADAMTS12-induced genes to reference single-cell RNA sequencing dataset indicated that ADAMTS12 primarily drives the differentiation to an injury-response fibroblast subpopulation. Both expand early after injury, but have a yet unknown role in fibrosis. Assuming a migration-associated phenotype of those injury-response fibroblasts, we decided to directly investigate cell migration using LISA imaging. Tracking each cell's migration speed in a 24-hour time-lapse, we found a significantly accelerated migration in fibroblasts expressing catalytically active, but not inactivated ADAMTS12. We concluded that substrate cleavage of ADAMTS12's catalytic domain drives fibroblast migration. But the key question was yet unanswered. Which substrate does ADAMTS12 cleave to do so? To tackle this, we isolated the extracellular matrix from ADAMTS12 knockout and wild-type fibroblasts to perform mass spectrometry. As expected, ADAMTS12 was the most significantly reduced protein in the knockout cells. But interestingly, none of its known substrates were differentially expressed. Instead, the fibulin HMCN1 was by far the most enriched protein. That led us to hypothesize whether ADAMTS12 cleaves HMCN1 in wild-type cells. To test this, we performed a digestion assay by incubating both proteins together for 24 hours and then detected HMCN1 using a Western blot. Here we confirmed a dose-dependent cleavage of HMCN1 by ADAMTS12, identifying HMCN1 as, in our view, novel substrate of ADAMTS12. Finally, by inhibition of HMCN1 expression using siRNA, we confirmed that the cleavage of HMCN1 by ADAMTS12 actually drives fibroblast migration.
Overall, our study highlights the novel mechanism of fibroblast activation. We show that after injury, fibroblasts upregulate ADAMTS12. Subsequently, ADAMTS12 cleaves the ECM protein HMCN1, which enables fibroblast migration from the perivascular niche and induces a specific injury-responsive fibroblast polarization. Ultimately, increased fibroblast activation exaggerates fibrosis and drives loss of organ function.